Sup, Rotten? So today, I'm doing something a little different. As many of you may know, I'm a complete sucker for apps, especially on the Mac. I go out of my way to look for what's new on the scene or to come across older gems that never came on my radar before. With this new series I'm doing, I want to do overviews of specific things I find interesting enough to cover, in this case, an app, and leave it to you guys whether or not you think it'll be worth it to add to your workflow or not. I call it Rotten Showcase. Genius, I know. Today, we will be checking out the powerful app TextBlaze, the sponsor behind this episode. Some of you may know TextBlaze, being that it's the number one rated productivity Google Chrome extension. However, I don't use Chrome. I use Arc, which in my head is a completely different browser even though it uses Chromium. Shut up. Anyway, we will be talking about their recent venture into the app scene with their very own Mac app, aiming to have us Mac users save a ton of time with its key features set to speed up productivity. Now, TextBlaze is a text expanding productivity tool that aims to make words or phrases that you type often way more optimized with automation. It works on any app on Mac where you can type, like your Notes app, your Mail app, or your internet browser of choice. And yes, TextBlaze is free forever to use, but if you're aiming to use it beyond its limits, there are a few affordable paid options that allow you to do so. First, let's head to their site with the link provided in the description below, where you will see their download button for Macs along with the tutorial button. There's a download option for both Apple Silicon and Intel-based Macs, which is a huge plus. Apple Silicon has been out for 4 years now, and it's nice to avoid using Rosetta-based software if you don't have to, you know? And for the Mac lap warmers, there's something for you too. So just hit download, double-click, and drag to applications, and then open. From there, the app will ask you to grant accessibility permissions for it to work properly. So let's go ahead and do that by clicking grants and hitting the TextBlaze toggle. From there, you just approve it with your password or Touch ID, depending on your keyboard, make an account, and you're in. Very straightforward stuff. From here, you're greeted with a text box and some demo snippets to try out. Snippets are essentially triggers that you set with a shortcut and then expand it to the word or phrase you want. Think of it as your own personal sleeper agent. As soon as you insert a shortcut, the text will then activate and say whatever you assigned it to say. It's really useful stuff. As you can see, typing out the demo word /sig activated the text, immediately turning it into more text. Now let's make a fresh one. Let's say you had to go to work, but you didn't want to miss a fresh upload from yours truly, so you decide to blow it off. Very realistic scenario, I'm sure. Anyway, you start by making a new snippet by clicking on the plus sign. In this first box, you name the snippet. In this case, we'll call it I'm busy. Now it's important to label the shortcut something you'll never realistically say to avoid activating a snippet when you don't want to. Starting the shortcut with a backslash usually does the trick, so let's just use /BSY for busy. Now in the text box below, you type in what you would want the snippet to say when activated. So let's put, sorry, I will be unavailable today because any day that Ryan Apple uploads, I treat as a national holiday. Don't blame me, I don't make the rules. See you tomorrow. Perfect. And because this snippet works universally on my Mac, I can now use it in any app I want to. Isn't that cool? I hope you can see the various possibilities this gives you. And believe me, I'm only scratching the surface with this. And there's more. We can take it even a step further by using these things called placeholders. Now for an example here, instead of me saying the word today, I can instead replace it with a time date format placeholder. Therefore, the date and time will automatically be updated without me manually having to put it myself every single time. I can use this snippet on any day and the date will always be accurate. And on top of that, I can use the AI write feature to make it sound a little bit nicer, to soften the blow, because I don't want to get fired. Because I care. I do. But hey man, priorities are priorities. I bet now you can see the time-saving potential an app like this can grant you. If you're curious, there will be a link in the description below to check it out. Again, free of charge. So, what do you think about the TextBlaze app? Let me know in the comments. And shout out to my Ryan and Ryan Pro patrons, Vasco, Franskobeck, Kerry Keck, and Takazma for supporting me on Patreon. Relevant links will be provided in the description below. Thanks for watching. And if you want to see more of me, you know what to do. TextBlaze is cool and all, but when are we going to get a Mac app to help us cook and clean? You know what I'm saying? Like, give us a hug when we need it. See, I would get therapy if there was a Mac app for that.